Hey folks, Sirdar here. In this episode of Dev with Sirdar, we're going to look at the structure of a modern Python project, how to lay out the files in the directory, what the most important pieces are, and how to keep things organized going forward. New Python projects should, whenever possible, be laid out according to the guidelines listed by the Python Packaging Authority. Even if you don't plan on distributing your project, this is still a good idea because it gives you a set of standards for how things behave and where people expect things to be found. To understand better, let's look at an actual project. This is a project that I've shown here from time to time in different incarnations. It's my implementation of Conway's Game of Life in Python. The first thing you'll ask is, where do I put my actual code? Well, all your project code goes in a subdirectory named source, src. You can place your code directly in source, or you can subdivide it into other directories for the sake of namespacing parts of the project. For this one, I have the core of my project under Conway, that's the main namespace, and another piece of it in render. That's a component written in Cython and compiled to C. I do recommend using at least one namespace directory as it makes organization easier. Next, we have files in the root of the repository. For Python projects, the common and most important thing to have here is the pyproject.toml file. That's the file format that's now used to store Python-specific metadata about a project. Don't be intimidated by all the things you see in this example. If you're just getting a project going, these lines here at the top are the only ones you really need. The project section declaration, the name, which is the name that's listed for your project when you use pip install to install it, the version number, and the dependencies, if there are any. Everything else can be ignored for now. There's a link down in the description for the video about where to learn more about what goes into a pyproject.toml file. Another thing that does appear in the root of a Python project is setup.py. Most of what's now in pyproject.toml used to live in setup.py, not all of it. Setup.py is run when your program is installed with pip, and it contains actual Python code instead of just data to do things that cannot be expressed in pyproject.toml alone. For instance, in this project, it's used to compile that C extension module written in Cython. So while setup.py is not mandatory, it's there for projects that need it, and some projects really do need it. So the next set of items after this, these are optional but common. First is your gitignore file, used to keep some files out from being checked into version control. You generally do not want to check in your virtual environment. You don't want to check in any PyCache directories or any egg-info files. Those are generated by pip install. I have a few other file types and directories listed here, but those are specific to this project, and these three types are really the things that you need to keep out of version control. Next is any documentation that goes with the project. In this case, all I have is a simple README file in Markdown format. If you have documentation that's auto-generated using Sphinx or a similar tool, you typically place that in a subdirectory named docs. Next is any license for your code. I do recommend having a license of some kind, even if you don't plan on distributing it. You never know. I have the MIT license as my default. It's widely used, it's easy to set up and customize, and everyone understands it. And finally, there's directories for tests. One common way to set up testing is to have a main module in that directory, so you can just run all your tests with py-m tests. My own test suite for this program, by the way, is exceedingly minimal. Don't take it as a model for anything, but the idea for how to deploy it should be clear. So to sum up, modern Python projects have a few mandatory pieces to make them compliant with Python standards. The location of the code and the pyproject.toml file, those are the two biggest. Things like licensing, documentation, tests, and so on can be added after the fact, and they should be, but the layout of the source files and the metadata are the two things that matter the most. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.